23rd problem from the primer. A pentagonal lamina having edges 25 mm placed on one of its corner. It is resting on one of its corner on HP. It is resting on HP with one of its corner means corner should be left side of the XY line. And then the bisector passing through the corner on which lamina rest is inclined 30 degree to HP and 45 degree to VP. Draw the projection. I will explain this bisector in the problem. Now we'll move on for resting on one of its corner. Resting on one of its corner on HP. On HP is there and it is resting on one corner means corner should come left side of the XY line. Now take 25 mm line, that is 25 mm dimension. Take 25 mm dimension which is perpendicular to the XY line. First you have to take for 25 mm dimension perpendicular to the XY line. And then take angle on either side 108 degree inside angle. So 108 or 72 outside. So 108. On either side you have to take 108 90 100 108. Then join these two points with thin line till only 25 mm is required, but still we will join. On either side you have to join these two points, that is 108 degree lines, and then cut these lines by 25 mm. Now we will take the 25 mm distance from these two points. Now we will cut this line by 25 mm on either side, and then from the same point once again we will cut one more arc on either side. From this point now we'll cut. Now we got 4 points, that is now we'll call it as A, this is B, this is C, this is D. Now we'll join with the dark lines. Right, now we got a pentagon E. So one side is equal to 25 and it is resting on one of its corner, that is corner is left side of the XY line. Now we'll draw the projector. So once again for 25 mm, we'll draw the projector till it intersect XY line. With thin line you have to draw. Now we'll take the parallel lines. So these two points will be joining each other at one point. So we'll take one more projector and then parallel to this from A point. Till it intersect XY line. Now give the arrow mark for that and then join these points. And when you are weaving from this side, this is A dash, B dash is visible, E dash is not visible inside the bracket. C dash is visible, D dash is not visible inside the bracket. Now first position is over. Second position, they are told the bisector. Bisector is nothing but, so parallel you have to take to draw this. So we'll take parallel line. So otherwise you can take parallel to XY line. So this is called as parallel, that is bisector. From the corner, from this A corner, it should divide the opposite edge by equal parts. This is 25 means 12.5 this side, 12.5 this side. Equally it is dividing. So that is called as bisector. Just as shown, now we'll divide it by 25 mm. That is 25 mm will be divided into 12.5. Now we'll join these two points, A and this point, so that is called as bisector. For this I will give M1, for this I will give M1, just for reference purpose. And then the bisector is nothing but the distance A to this, A to C dash, D dash is inclined. They have given the bisector of the edges passing through the corner on which it rests inclined 30 degree to HP. It is resting on HP. HP angle you have to consider at the beginning. So A to C dash D dash, A to C dash D dash is the distance. It is inclined at an angle of 30 degree. Now we will mark one point and we will take 30 degree. Now mark 30 degree line and draw the line with thin lines. And then this point is called as A dash point. And then cut the distance by other distances by taking this line. Now this is A, this is C and D. Now by keeping at A point, we will cut this by C and D. C dash, D dash will get here. Then we will take the distances from C dash, D dash to D dash, E dash. There we will get D dash and E dash distance. Now the lamina, complete lamina has transferred at 30 degree line. So this is 30 degree line inclined to VPHP. Only that lamina should be made up, then go for drawing the projector. From A point till it intersect A, A is here, so then B and E. Till it intersect B and E. Then from C and D, C and D, and give the arrow mark arrow marks indicating how this projector will be drawn, from which side the projector will be drawn. Now we'll draw horizontal lines. So this is M and A will get here, then we'll move on for E point till it intersect E. So this is E point, this is B point, and then C will get C point here. And then D point. I've got all the points. This is D point. We'll join all points. So arrow mark should be drawn. Arrow mark shows where these lines will be drawn, from where. So this is A to B. Then from B to E, then C to D, then D to E, then C to B. So this is the top view of second position. Now we'll go for third position. What is third position? This bisector. Now AM. This bisector is AM1, original after inclination with 30 degree. So we got AM. Now the bisector is inclined. This bisector is inclined 45 degree. Now in the problem, no appears. If no appears, bisector appears, no locus line. In this problem, there is no appear, because of that we'll get a locus line. So because of that, we'll draw first 45 degree line. So we'll mark 45 degree here, then we'll draw the 45 degree line from that point. If there is no bisector, you should draw like this only. Join these points with thin lines. With thin line you have to draw. Then mark one point, that is A point, on this. So this is 45 degree line we got from the question. So I will mark A point here, and then we'll take this AM distance, right? We'll take this A to M1 distance, and then from A point we'll draw arc from A point, and that point we'll call it as M1 because we have taken the distance from A to M1. Now I have drawn arc by taking the distance from the A. Now we'll draw a locus line from that point. So we'll take parallel with XY line, or you can take the parallel with this. We'll draw a locus line from this. Now call it as locus of M, because A M1 distance I have taken. By keeping at A point, I have cut that distance by arc on 45 degree line, we got M1. Now take the distance of AM. M1 turned it there. Now I have to take AM distance. This is the AM distance. After 30 degree inclination, change in AM distance has been observed. So now keep at A point and cut this locus line. Keeping at A point, cut the locus line, then join these two points A and M. With thin line and extend it. Now this point is called as M. On M you have to draw this complete pentagon. You have to draw with this line. We'll make the dark. We'll make this line dark. On that line AM, now we got AM points. On that AM you have to draw this complete pentagon and measure this angle. We should get around 55. We'll get 55 degree. We can check later. Now we'll construct. Now we'll take these distances. That is M to D, or you can take M to C. Check both the distances are same. So from M side, by keeping at M, we'll draw arc on either side. And then take the distance from A to C. A to C distance. Or can take A to D, both are same. So by keeping at A point, cut these two arcs, where we will get C and D point. Now we join A, M. So all these three points should be in the same line. All these should be in the same line. Just I'm rotating and keeping here. So rotating, keeping here. This is C point. This is D point I got. Now, by D or C, now we have D point there. So we'll take D to E distance. Or you can take C to B distance. Both are same. So we'll draw arc from this point. Then from D point, then take distances from A. From A to E, or can take A to B distance. Both are same. So by keeping at A point, we'll cut these arcs on either side. So we got D point, E point. Now we join all the points. From C it is B. And then from A it is D. Then from E point, E to A. And then D to E. So you should follow this construction regularly, continuously. Then it will be practiced. Then we will draw the projector from all the points. With thin line you have to draw. Then from CD, now we have drawn three projectors from ABCD front V. I will draw projector from the top. from A C point till C. Then from B point till it intersect B, then from D point then A point then E point. So we got all the points, just give the arrow mark for that. Now C is intersecting at this point C dash. Next B is here, that is called as B dash point. Next A point, that is D point is here, then E are coming and intersecting at that point. So this point is called as A dash. Now you got all the points, just join A to B. Next from B to C. Next C to D. Next E point, E to D. And then A to E. So this I have to construct when the median is inclined at an angle of 45 degree. When median inclined, you will get this locus line. When median inclined, if there is an appears word, if an appears word directly this median is inclined. Here there is no appears word in the problem inclined to VP. Hence you will get a locus line.